I've played since like Shadow of the Colossus. I'm not even kidding. I really love this game. Oh, I mean, it's so much fun because even though like it's really annoying that you die so much, it's like such like clear and evident proof of just being human. Being human to me is basically progress plus emotion. So if you're doing the same thing over and over again, or if you're stagnant and you have no emotion, then you are a robot, in my opinion, by my definition. You must live to be human. And I love progress, man. All right. Such deep thoughts and wisdom, indeed. Indeed. All right, so here's where we gotta play serious mode. Oh man, come on, Luigi. We've got big plans for you, buddy. Yeah, I try and keep my commentary low key. I keep everything subtle and chill, relaxed, and laid back. As you can see in the title, it's a chill stream, cause it's a late night stream. Oh man, we got to the hard part so easily this time. A fun game. This is a fun game! Oh man, I hesitated, you guys. Just a tiny bit. Just a little tiny bit. Alright. Oh man. I had it! I was so close! Alright. Take 33. Thank you for the follow! Remember the Elamode! I like your name. I think that's an awesome name to have. Glad you are here. Hope you're enjoying yourself. Hope you enjoy the deaths and the fails and the anti-successes that we're experiencing. Because I sure am. We can definitely do this. I believe. This is not actually a hard level. So, despite everything that's going on, we're getting places. Dang it. Everything has a reason. You don't have to memorize levels. You don't have to be perfect. You just have to be pretty dang good. And if you think you are, then you can take this game on. Yeah, I don't like RPGs. I feel like platformers are the complete opposite of RPGs. Turn-based. Chaos Edition. Yes, a lot of people have suggested Super Mario 64 Chaos Edition. I'm probably not going to play it because I've seen people play it. And it looks kind of nuts. I will play Super Mario 64 Star Road. Remember the Elamode! The last levels look pretty glitzy. You think so? Have you played this? I think this game is crazy. Crazy. Crazy hard. Crazy fun. And... yeah, Tame is right. I mean, you're free to recommend anything that's an actual game. But, take a fair warning. The RPGs, especially turn-based RPGs, are going to be the low man on the totem pole. Alright, there, we've triggered the wind. No! Dang it, you guys, it's so hard. A third time? What? I can't imagine you had to try something three times to succeed. Well, in a speedrun, if you have to do something three times, it's like a reset. All right. Yes. There we go. All right. The first game was 85. 29 and 28. I don't know what you're talking about, Nose. Oh man, you cannot hesitate at all. I know that so well, but I just get so nervous when you're making those jumps. And it's like this one moment that you've been looking forward to. It's like, imagine if you haven't seen your parents in years, and then they're gonna come and see you. They're gonna fly out to Alaska, get on that plane, the plane opens, the door is there. And then they say, I love you. And then you hesitate to respond. And then they feel nervous. And then you fall down the pit. That's exactly what this is like. Oh, sweet. Okay, we did it. I'm gonna pause, take a break, relax, chill, get a drink of water. I'm not nervous. About success. Yes. Yes. Gotta count the small victories. Gotta go slow. They go one step at a time. Because this is where they're ready to trip you up. With this little silly stuff. But I won't be fooled. I won't be tricked. And I won't be beaten. I'm gonna do it. Are you kidding? What is this? Oh, sweet. Thank goodness. There's a thing here. Okay, sweet. Yes! Oh my gosh, we did it. Okay, sweet. Okay. I can breathe. I can breathe. A 16-day marathon at MGS? That sounds pretty sweet. Did you recommend Aladdin? I think so. I'm down to take on Aladdin for Super Nintendo. We did it, you guys. Ah, you can't break these blocks. DuckTales, yes, I'm down to try DuckTales. A buck toothpaste. I like it, that's neat. Thank you. Alright. We're gonna go over here. Dang it. It's dedication. He doesn't? Wait a minute, we got a checkpoint? Are you kidding me? That's crazy. I'm blown away by that. I've never gotten a checkpoint on my first time through a level, like, ever. I bet there's a way up. There's definitely a way up. No! Dang it. Yeah, I do stay positive. No point in being negative. I stay positive because I know we're gonna succeed! Ah, oh, dang it. He's so slidey, man. The people I know would feel the rage! No, man, I stay positive because I'm enjoying the heck out of this game. This is the most fun Mario game that I've played. Honestly, I like this more than Mario World, than Mario 3. Because of mechanics, basically. So I had actually a couple problems with the mechanics in Mario World. So my main problem was just that the fact that you can get a ton of power-ups, leave the level, and then go back in that level. Like, be like, oh, I'm having a ton of trouble with this level. Let me go, like, get a Yoshi, get huge, get a cape, and all this stuff. And then, now I'm super powered, now I have like 0% chance of failure. If I do fail, no big deal, I'll just leave the level, go back, hit it all again. The reason why that's a problem, Ratmus, is because... then, like, if you're like Rockman or something, then it's no big deal, you just do it every time, and you beat every level with the cape and stuff. If it's like your first time through, though... it's really bad because then you have to just... oh, man, it pushes you off if you're at the top. Alright, see you later, Red. See you later, man. It's a problem because then you have to decide between your time. Like, do I want to leave this level and get powered up every single time I attempt this level? Or do you want to spend more time having a higher chance of failure? Like, going into the level every single time as small Mario? But then spend more time actually playing the level? Versus spending that time dying more, well, spending that time going and getting a bunch of power-ups, having more chance of dying, but you also don't spend the time basically grinding. So that's what I didn't like about Super Mario World. And that sounds insignificant, but it was actually a pretty big deal. In Super Mario 3, the problem was just with the save system. Yeah, you can save, but that ship is gonna, every time you continue, that airship Bowser has is gonna move around, gonna do a ton of stuff that's wait a minute. What the heck do you do here? How do you get past this? That's pretty silly. I don't know how to do that. I guess you gotta go up and over. That's a legitimate question. How do you get past that? But Super Mario World, like, you had to repeat progress a lot, which I really don't like, because that airship moves the heck around on its own terms. I wonder if you can do something fancy like this. I think you actually have to do something fancy like that. No milk chocolate! Dark chocolate is the best! I agree, dark chocolate is amazing. Like, what do you do here? You can run over the small gaps. Okay, awesome. Let's try that then. I fell! Dang. I was holding the run button. I'm guessing that you mean when you fall. Like, you can fall and start running from when you initially jump on the platform. Dang it. And that's probably what you're supposed to do. It sucks that we gotta restart this whole level, though. Like, the reason this game is so great is because there's no crazy power-up. There's nothing like, oh, I leave the level and I power up. There's also nothing, basically no overworld. plus infinite lives makes it a lot better than the other Mario games. Because then you always start a small Mario, so it's always completely fair. Whether I'm playing it, whether someone who knows all the crazy secrets is playing it, you're always going to stay as small Mario, and you can't really get big! And then the other thing is, if you die a lot, it's not punishing. You just get to restart the level, and it's like, okay, I can beat one level at a time. So it's very fair and forgiving. Even though this looks hard, even though I am dying a lot, it's incredibly forgiving. Which is the nice thing. You just did your first stream ever! Awesome, Momo! I'm glad to hear that, man. Good for you. Hope you had fun. It's a ton of fun streaming. It's a lot of work, though. It's a ton of fun. I'm glad you got it all working on Mac. I know you were having some trouble with that. Chocolate is good! This is true. Chocolate is good. Cannot argue with that logic. You're gonna go rest. Alright, go get yourself some rest, Ash. Thank you for being here, man. I really appreciate it. Thank you for being awesome and for hanging out with us. It's been awesome having you around. See, Ratmus, I was holding the run button, but I still just die. Like, I don't understand this. Can you repeat all that? Repeat all what? List of highlights. Awesome. I was just explaining, like, how important it is that there's no overworld in this game. See you later, Ash. Nearly lost all your cookies! No! Don't lose the cookies! The cookies are hype! The cookies are awesome! Dang it. The cookies are exciting. The cookies are awesome to have them around. Cookies are delicious. Alright. Yeah, so basically, the problem with Mario World, I think you said you were playing Mario World. In Mario World, you can leave, like, if you're having trouble with a level, every single time. What? No face bot? Yeah, sorry, AK Narcissus. I got a really bad haircut. I know it's a lame excuse, but it's actually true. So that's why I don't want to use a webcam right now. Hang on, I need to test and figure out what the heck is going on here. What? It worked that time. That's silly. Well, I guess Ratmus was right. Sweet, we beat the level! Awesome! We did it! Good to see you. AK Narcissus! How's your day going, man? Welcome to the stream, having the first ever official late night stream where people harass- No, man. No one was harassing me. The thing was, I just got an actual really bad haircut. And I really didn't like it at all. I showed everyone earlier. I had two streams today. I showed everyone earlier, and I really don't like it. It's not the worst. I just really don't like my haircut. I'm gonna give it like a week. Let it grow out. Helping a friend remodel their house. Neat. That's awesome. Good for you, man. Because my hair is like my pride. Yay, this is fun. I like, oh man, my platform goes away. Yay, a new platform. Yay. Yay, we're getting places. Wait a minute, I heard that noise. The ba-bomb. noise that's like, you did something wrong. Ah, dang it. Yes, let us see the hair. Yeah, I can turn on my webcam for a second. It's your pride. Why would you cut your precious hair? I don't know. It's because I was seeing my family over the weekend, and I know they were going to be like, oh my gosh, you need a haircut. And they were going to be like horrified and be like, you don't take care of yourself at all. Yes, I did beat it. Welcome back, Artaxian. Welcome back. Progress. For someone who shows me. Yeah, that is really cool. Well, now we're on a new rage-inducing level. That you can watch. We can all enjoy together. The thing... Wait a minute. There's something going on wrong here. It's giving me the sound of... You did not succeed. What am I supposed to do? It's making the sound of... Do not go this way. Maybe I have to go up? Do we have any experts of this game here? Yeah, I'm dying in the same place. It's, Why am I streaming late? Because my work was super stressful today. I needed to chill and relax and hang out with everyone. I think you gotta go up to just find things in life. Yes, you're right. You are so right. Cake fun stuff. I agree. Wait a minute, what? Does anyone know what you're supposed to do on this level? It's an infinite, in case you haven't noticed, it's infinitely repeating the same over and over and over again. Is that what I was supposed to do all along? Okay, great, cool, we did it. Awesome, we're making progress. Dang it. Well, we're making progress. No, it wasn't actually stressful. I actually didn't mind at all. I just like acting like I'm a normal person. I am so unaffected by stress. I want to say normal things sometimes. Like, what do normal people say? The baby was crying all night. And stuff like that. Or, I missed my car insurance payment. I don't know. I'm trying to think of, like, the most average thing you can say. Why did you lie to me? I don't know. Well, to be fair, it actually is more work than it normally is. It's okay to be magic and not stressed. Well, okay, so technically it is a little bit more stressful than it normally is. Cause instead of like being able to chill for a couple minutes between calls, like that's why I normally watch streams while I'm at work. The dingo ate your baby. I don't know what that voice is. Normally, on a normal day, on a non-end-of-the-year day, I can just chill and relax between calls. Like, there might be a minute or two. Yeah, you can call me Jim. You can call me whatever you want. But when it's the end of the year, then it's non-stop. Like, there's no breaks between calls except for... except when you're on your official breaks. So it's like Sundays are the least work. Because then it might be like 10 or 15 minutes between calls, which is crazy. On a normal day, it's like a couple minutes. Like, that's why I'm always hanging out in people's streams when I'm at work. Oh man, that was a clutch moment. We did the things there. But mom, we had to kill 3 more zombies to get to the next level. Yeah. Oh my gosh! You guys, I'm gonna Mario it up. I mean, Luigi it up. You're right, Tommy. You are so completely right. MLG strats! Yes, our tag team! You are so right! I really, really like it when people are supportive and stuff. It's cool. I mean, I don't mind when people are trolling and saying, like, bad stuff. But I do really, really appreciate it when people are nice. Dang it. Everyone needs nicknames! Yes, they do! Yes, they do. I like the sound of that idea. Alright, we'll go play some TF2. Hope you enjoy yourself, man. That sounds like a ton of fun. Has been shutting off sound for you? What? Why? That's not good. Sound is not working. No! Oh my gosh. Rockman, Ratmus, if you're still here, this level's crazy. See you later, Pimple. See ya. What time is it? It's 11:14. Think about turning into an animal? I don't know cake fun stuff. I never thought about that. Alright, well let's keep rolling. Been regular for you as well. No, that sucks, man. I'm sorry to hear that. Bullfrog! What is up, man? Yes! Welcome back! Yes, we are right back at it! Glad to see- Bunnytails! Dude, what's up? Lady Bunnytails, welcome to the stream. Good to see you. How are you doing? Well, dang it, I died again. Welcome! How's everything going? It's really cool to see you. I was looking in your channel earlier, Bunnytails. I didn't really understand the game. I don't really know new games, but I rated Bryce after when I had to go to work. And then I was watching his stream from work, and then I was lurking in your stream after he raided you, so that was kind of cool. But welcome. Hope your stream went well earlier. Seemed like a really fun game. I had to mute the stream, so that's why. I was a dirty lurker! But at least I was able to watch, and it's kind of cool. But yeah. Really good to have you here. We are doing the thing. We're playing, supposedly, the hardest Mario game of all time. It is Mario 2. It is a really intense game. Dang it. There is a ton of stuff that will kill you left and right. Yeah, as Rockman said, every level is crazy. And Irritating Pimple's waiting. All right, sweet. Well, glad you're here, chilling out while you're waiting for the TF2, buddy. Pimple. And yeah, alright, here we go. And it's actually really forgiving, though. Which is the cool thing about this game, is that like when you die, you get right back in it. You don't have to worry about repeating old levels or anything like that. You just get right back into the level you were working on. It's very reminiscent of modern games like Wings of V. I'm sure you've seen people play Wings of V, where like they have this one part that they keep dying on, but then once they get past that part, it's a new part that they keep dying on. So that's exactly what this is like, which is like strangely comforting, because you only have to worry about one thing at a time. And it's like constantly just delivering new content and new challenges. And once you get past the challenges of one level, you may not have to face them again, which is really cool. It's really neat design. Because I would call you a... What? Yeah, I know sometimes people check the viewer list. I actually check my own viewer list sometimes. Very, very rarely. But it's cool because sometimes there are people who just, like, are there for every stream or, like, a lot of streams. How long have I back at it? I've been, let's see. So, I've been playing this game for another 2.5 hours. I streamed for 3 hours earlier, so it's five? Yeah, 5.5 hours in total. That's like an hour per world or so. That's pretty good progress, I should think. Dang it. I should think. Maybe another hour. Maybe 6 hours. I don't know. But I think we're doing pretty well. I mean, yes, we are dying a lot. That is true. But this game is, like, really forgiving, in my opinion. No, you're not. I do the same thing, Cake Fun Stuff. I do the exact same thing. I'm, like, so ready for that package to arrive. Yes. Let's wait for this thing to move. I'm watching that platform off to the right side. I'm trying to catch up with... Dang it! Man, that platform doesn't really help you at all, actually. I should have just went for the red Koopa instead. Yeah. Yeah, Bullfrog knows! How the tracking numbers are. The tracking number lifestyle. You never received a notification! No! I'm sorry, AK Noxus. But I was! I was on earlier. I really try my best, AK Narxus, to be consistent about my regular stream time, which is just 1 p.m. Eastern time every single day except Sundays. I was not on Saturday because I had family obligations, but other than that, I really try and be on for at least 3 hours a day except Sundays. As long as nothing gets in my way. Oh, dang. Or nothing stops me like that, then, yeah, that's what I try and do. I'm not even convinced I should be using Luigi for this level. But, I don't know, some of these jumps just seem so difficult. I feel like the little bit of extra difficulty that comes with using Luigi is balanced out because some things are exponentially harder as Mario. That's kind of crazy. It's actually really cool. Wow, that was a crazy jump. I don't even... Yeah, see? That's the kind of stuff I'm talking about. Like, Luigi, yeah, he is hard to control. But he can also do the craziest tricks. How bad is your delay? I don't know. You can test it by seeing the on-screen chat. It sounds like Twitch has been having a lot of trouble tonight. Alright, well, let's see where we can go. Oh, that's why that platform's there, so you can get back up if you're down. Yeah, see, that's the kind of moment I'm talking about. There's no way Mario would have been able to do that. 11 a.m. Pacific time. Sounds about right. Except I believe I should have started around 10 a.m. Pacific time. Oh, I almost had that too. I just need to wait a little bit more on that first... platform. Testing. Your test just went through! So I actually don't even need these Koopas. Watch this madness. Boom! That is such a cool jump. Like, is that not amazing? Are you not entertained? There we go. Yeah, that's how I... I'm actually really glad you said that, Cake Fun Stuff, because I completely agree with some of the level of challenge on some of these things. Definitely seems like it should be a fan-made game. Alright. That boom? What boom? A sonic boom? The boom of my voice? My super deep, manly voice? Shouty scary split. I'm sorry. Oh, did I speak too loud? I apologize. Maya Han is a fan of himself. He is. He really is. I'm sorry if I scared you all. I did my Batman voice. Look at that. Dang it, I overjumped. You don't think it's fan-made. Dude, I definitely suggest it, though. This game is amazing. I don't know if it's as fun watching it as it is playing it, but I love this game. More than life itself. This is gonna go up in the Hall of Fame with Perfect Dark and Shadow of the Colossus and all my other favorite games. Because I am like euphorically happy playing this game. It's so much fun. It's like the perfect game. Like, this is exactly what a game is supposed to be. This is everything that I've been talking about for such a long time that a game should be. Really? You think so? Okay, well, I'm glad you enjoy watching it. Because it's yes! Yes! Oh, man, I'm just going to stick to Luigi forever. He can do such cool things like that. That is crazy cool. Yes! Oh, my gosh. You guys, we did it. We did it. I'm so happy. And that is, like, what makes it all worth it. Even though you die like a million times and it's really, really hard, you feel so good when you finally get through it. And it's like, wow. It makes you feel like a god among insects, to use a X-Men quote. That's what happens when, I think it's like Pyro or something, when the fire guy is like really embarrassed that he needs to start a fire. Well, he needs like a lighter or something to start using his power. And then Magneto's like, "You are still a god among insects." And it's a pretty cool moment in the movie. Dang it. Are you seeing Luigi? Yeah? That's a good point, Tame. I think you're completely right. Things are a lot harder as Luigi, though. A lot harder. Those are some good questions, Cake Fun Stuff. It's just so cool, because Luigi's like... so awesome. Dang it. He can do so much cool stuff. That's what you think when you're in pain? You're right. I actually do, like, the Mario philosophy is, like, slow and safe and consistent. Like, learning to do things really, really well. Luigi is all about YOLO strats. Like, hope this works. Like, the flashy stuff. Because the hard parts become easier as Luigi, and the easier parts become harder. Which is cool. I like that a lot. With Mario, most of the game is a lot easier, but then there are very specific jumps that are incredibly difficult. So Luigi, like, balances things out quite nicely. And I really like it a lot. Playing as, like, not only, like, the ability to be Luigi, but also just the choice that the game imbues you with. I'm sorry that you get stomach aches. That really sucks, man. I love choice. I love customization. I love hard games. Dang it. I can't even get past the... I think I gotta, like, work my way up to using Luigi. I'm not good enough to start out as him. Not in this level yet. I know I said I'm just gonna stick to Luigi, but I can't. Being as you die frequently, that's true. More information than needed, but glad you're alright. Yeah, I'm glad you're alright too. That's the important thing, man. Like, look at this. This is... Case in point. In just a second here, I'm gonna succeed with ease. And it'll be like, man, this was so much easier than what I was doing earlier. Dang it. I gotta let go of the run button when I'm in air. That's what I gotta do. You'd be so mad. Yeah, probably. Most likely. Kamikaze! Yeah, you're so right. You guys are completely right. Alright. Alright! Let's get in there. Go do the things. Yes. Death wish. I'm watching these patterns. See, that jump would be so... I'm gonna switch back to Luigi. I know these jumps would be like way, 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 way easier as Luigi. Actually, I don't know. I have no idea. Alright, we're up. We're gonna go places. I think he falls slower. When do I plan on finishing the stream? I don't know, maybe in an hour or two? I don't plan on streaming that much longer. Because I'm getting sleepy. It's been a long day. I've also been talking all day. Literally, like, since I woke up, let's see, about... I don't know, it's like 11:30 now. I woke up at 8:30, and I've literally been talking almost non-stop since I woke up. Since my job is constantly talking, streaming is constantly talking, and I love talking, so it's really good for me. Also kind of exhausting, though. Hang on. Taxi it never. Yes, I like Tommy's answer. Never. We will never stop. Twitch is so lag for me fast few days. Yeah, I like it, AK Narxus. We can definitely look into adding a death counter. I wanted to look into adding one before this second stream, but I was really busy with stuff, which kind of sucks. Oh man, that was so tricky. Begging for a death counter. Yeah, I know. Especially if I could map it to my controller. That would be really convenient. Alright. I can look into one tonight, though. All right. Let's keep going. Okay, sweet. But you didn't put it anywhere, so it got lost. No! You failed as a chat warrior. You tried as a fat wolf. As a chat. I almost said fat. As a chat warrior. And trying is success in itself. And that I like. I like success. There goes my brain. RIP. Spelling. Alright, but let's keep rolling. Let's keep trying. Keep going. Alright. Sometimes they combo, like right after, there's a second fireball. No, no! I said chat, not fat. Chat, not fat. Dang it, you guys. Alright. We're gonna keep living. We're gonna try to keep living. I'm on the life plan. I've got Lifeline. There's a really cool game called Lifeline. It's like a mic game. You need to tell the person what to do every step of the way. See, that time it double fire. Oh, man. I got too ambitious with that jump. Like, you want to play it safe, but at the same time. Yeah, I just noticed Big John is just signed online, so that's pretty cool. Playing Mega Man X. Alright. Alright. Walk around with a hunk of ham. That sounds awesome. Alright, see you later, cake fun stuff. Thanks for being here, man. It's been awesome having you here. I will see you later! No! I shouldn't have hesitated! Only one way out now! That's not the good way out. That was actually kind of ridiculous. There was no way for me to succeed. He is not there right now, but you'll keep watching. Okay. You like ham? Ham is pretty delicious. Yeah, I hope so too. I know you were asking the deep questions. And that sounds pretty involved, man. I think about that stuff too, though. All the time. Yeah, if only, AK Narcissus, if only we could get a mushroom. That would be pretty sweet. I'm 99.999% sure I hit jump. Maybe I hit it when I was still jumping. Hey Trex, what's up, man? Dude, good to see you. We're taking on this crazy game. If you want the lowdown, it's called Mario 2 The Lost Levels, the Japanese version of Mario 2. It's really hard, insanely punishing. It's actually not punishing. It's very forgiving. It's very difficult, but as soon as you fail, you get right back in the action. So I really like it a lot. It's really fun. Good to see you, man. How is your day? How is everything going? How are you? Hope you're doing good, man. This is the jump we're struggling with. Are you kidding? I know I hit the jump button. I know I did. But I just didn't quite get there. I'm gonna practice like jumping as soon as I land. So that I can get frame perfect jumps for those falling platforms. That's what we're gonna work on. Who's that? Tudster. Are you still here, Tudster? If you are. Or anyone else who plays Portal, I would actually be okay with, dang it, switching over to, if someone has some cool Portal custom levels that they want me to play, I would be cool with doing that for a bit. And I know we were talking about Portal 2 earlier. I don't know if you said you completed any levels or not. But if you want to see them played, we could do that. If you have completed ones.
Oh, jeez. Oh, jeez. You do! Oh, awesome.
Sweet. Well, then we can take on that challenge. We could... Let me find it. Deadster does. What we could do, we could even... Oh, dang it! We could put it to a vote. Let's, get some audience participation up in here. Let's make a straw poll. I actually don't know if I'm even going to follow through with what the straw poll says. But I want to see what you guys think. You have Portal 2. What to do for the next hour? Keep dying in 2. Play Tudster's custom levels in Portal 2. So we'll, let's make a straw poll and see what you guys think. Vote for what? Well, I don't even know if there's point in voting because I might just play Portal 2 anyway. But I like voting. I like making polls. But we're definitely going to beat this game. We're definitely not giving up. We'll never quit. We'll never give in. Never give up. But I am also down to play Portal 2 for a bit. You like working the polls. If you know what I mean. I know what you mean. I never know what people mean when they say that. I don't want to vote for both. I don't know if I made it where you can vote for both. The vote is split. I have not voted yet. I like straw polls though. I kind of just... With polls and voting and with the recommendation list and all that stuff, I kind of just take it all into consideration. I don't really decide based on any one factor. And that sounds like a good way to decide things, doesn't it? And that's why I say, quite often, there's no guarantees. Because I don't know what's going to happen. And I don't want people to be disappointed when things do or don't happen. No! Why didn't he jump? I could have swear I did the jump. Tudster, did you find what you were looking for? We're going to have to turn up the bitrate, though, for Portal, though. Back up to, like, 1400. Alright, continue. But yeah, if you guys want to see Portal, we can, switch games in a bit. Maybe. Maybe. Wow, that's cool. The poll's still split. Every time! You have to go. Alright. See you later, Artaxian. Thank you for being here. Thank you for being awesome. Got Link. Okay. Luigi doesn't want to jump. I believe he wants to jump. I don't know. It's just for like the last hour or so. I was considering switching games. Dang it. I can only take so much of this game sometimes, as much as I like it. You're natural at being awesome. Well, that is awesome. I'm glad you're awesome at being awesome. You're natural at being awesome, not awesome at being awesome. Well, you are awesome at being awesome if you're natural at being awesome. Yeah, the deaths are increasing.
All right.
Okay, those last three deaths were pretty fail fish. I'm gonna... Let's put up my break screen. Let's switch over games. And, switch to Portal 2. For a bit. And then... We'll do this for maybe an hour and then I'll end the stream probably. I know I didn't stream for that long today. Well, this stream hasn't been super long. But... You heard that curse? Failfish is an adjective? There was swearing? Swearing? Who is swearing? And why are they doing it? I don't care. People can swear if they want to. Did you get the death counter script? Oh, you sent it to my inbox? Oh, dude, what's up, Gadget TV man? Welcome to the stream. I'm actually in the middle of switching games right now. I've been playing... You got no idea if it's sent. I'm checking if it's sent. I did get it! Sweet! Thank you! I have not opened that up yet. But I do have it in my messages. I will get that taken care of. I'm switching over to Portal 2 right now. I am going to resume. I'm going to make a save state just to be completely sure that it's saved. I am going to resume Mario Lost Levels tomorrow at the usual time. But I need to chill for a bit. Relax. With some Portal 2, with some custom levels. But, yeah, thank you so much for sending me that message, man. I'm gonna, after the stream tonight, I'm gonna get that all set up. And then tomorrow, when we do resume the, Lost Levels, then we'll have that all set up, so then we can actually keep track of that. The deaths and everything, the death count, and all that cool stuff. But yeah, I really appreciate it, man. No problem. Awesome. Yeah, and glad you were able to stop back again. Normally, I don't stream this late. This is actually an anomaly for me. You will get dusty. Okay, Tommy. I will do my best to get that set up. Normally, I... Let's see. How do I find Splitter? Is that your level? I gotta find out how to find your levels. But yeah, normally I don't stream this late. Normally I actually don't even switch games midstream. But I don't know, man. I don't really follow stuff. I just do what I feel like. And welcome back. I actually streamed 24/7. That would be awesome. No, the one thing I do, there's two things I do. One thing is... How do I find levels by a friend? Let me show you guys what I'm looking at. Let me put the video capture. Game capture. Of Portal up. There. And increase my bitrate. We're gonna download some of Tudster's custom levels for Portal 2 and play them out, check them out, and they seem pretty fun. And I'm gonna increase my bitrate for this game. So let's see. Let's download those levels and then, yeah. And then it'll be awesome. But all the time. Yeah. So how do I find your custom level? Oh yeah, I have to go in the Steam Workshop, right? I think so. Community? Workshop! Featured? Oh, you posted a link to one of them. So what do I do? Do I subscribe to it? Yeah, if you want to BRB, this is a good moment to BRB, aka Narxxus, because we're figuring out how to download levels. So did it go through? So it might be a minute. Just 1 minute. Splitter. There we go. We got it. Sweet. Okay, we got your first level. Tudster, we are on it. Let me make sure we got sound. And make sure the sound is working. And sounds good. Volume is high enough. And not muted. Why is it muted?
You all know the cloud.
Oh my gosh. That was incredibly loud. At least for me. I hope it wasn't that loud for you guys.
Camera technology. It's getting its picture taken. So this will have to be on the honor system.
There's no chat on stream. Okay. Let me fix that. Order. Bottom. There we go.
Will whoever started testing early please go outside so they can be consumed by the cloud?
Okay. So this is Tudster's custom level. Let me make sure the game title changed. Quaternary or Quaternary? Okay. Sweet. So we are on the Portal 2 plane. Oh. I just found a level? What? What is this crap? This is madness. Back. Okay. Quiet as heck. Alright, it should be working now. Everything should be working now. But yeah, for those of you who came for Mario Lost Levels, we'll be resuming that tomorrow at 1 p.m. Eastern Time. It's gonna be pretty sweet. And for now, kind of want to just chill and play some Portal for a bit. And check out these levels. Quaternary. Everything's too quiet for you? Or the game sounds too quiet? Well, this is the game sound. Not a whole lot to hear. But if things are too quiet, we can turn them up. Supposed to rhyme with ordinary? No. It's not! Wait a minute. Where are we supposed to go? Alright. So what can we do? What can we see? And where can we portal? We can go here. And now we can push ourselves wherever we want. The game is almost muted. Really? I didn't know the game volume was that low. Let me turn the game volume up then. Okay. Okay, I like doubled the game volume here. Oh my gosh, I just killed myself. Alright, tell me if that's better. Yeah, the background music is supposed to be quiet. The whole game's kind of quiet. But the action doesn't sound loud enough. It's almost inaudible, okay. Well, thanks for the feedback. Get it? It's kind of an audio pun. Because if feedback is like your mic's giving a lot of feedback, it's like a bad thing. Whooshy portal noise. Is that better? I turned the game volume up from like 15 or 20% to like 50%. So it should make a pretty big difference. If that's not enough, we can turn it up more and more and more until it completely drowns out my voice. But yeah, so I guess we're pushing ourselves through the places. Well, give me bad umpch. Yeah. Yeah, the pun. All right, so okay. So if I kill this block, it should make a new one. That's depressing. All right, cube. Let's go. So if you guys don't know what Portal is or how it works, it's a puzzle game. In case you're not familiar. You've got this gun where you can shoot portals wherever you want. And you just gotta solve the puzzles. So that turned off that tractor beam. I don't know what good that does. You're not back. Okay. Well, I'm not glad that you're not back. What is this, opposite thing? The question is, like, why would you want to turn off the tractor beam? I think the answer is so that you can get infinite momentum doing this. What else can you do in that room? And how did I get over there in the first place? And where else can you get momentum? I don't know. I don't know. But I will figure it out. Is this green enough? That is pretty green, mister. That is pretty green. Wait, what does this switch do again? I don't know what that switch does. Goes all the way over there? To that? You have to hit two switches. Hey, mister. Hey, mister, indeed. So you have to hit two switches, it looks like. To do the thing. Two of them. Why two? You need to head off. Alright, see you later, Gadget. TV man. Thank you for being here. Thank you for sending me that death counter message. I'll definitely get it set up for tomorrow. I really appreciate it. I'm really glad you were able to be here. Thanks for coming with the raid and for hanging out with us tonight. It's been awesome having you around, man. And like I said, I will be resuming Lost Levels tomorrow at 1 p.m. Eastern time. But see you later, man. Yes, I did get it. It's in my messages. I just, have been busy. Oh, well, actually, I didn't check my messages yet. Until just now. But I'll get it set up for tomorrow. Will do. What is the point of this? There's something that stopped this cube from being on this switch. And I think it might have been that switch over there. How do you even push that switch down? You gotta push the cube? You gotta have a tractor beam from there and push the cube on top of it, I guess? That's the only thing I can think of. Well, let's test. So what we know we can do, we can drop this here. That turns off the tractor beam. We're not sure why you would want to do that. You can fling yourself here, which flings yourself here. Then I believe if I hit the switch, it should turn on that tractor beam again. So it does. Okay, cool. So if you hit the switch, it drops down a box there, which turns off the tractor beam. Which is good? Question mark? I don't know if that's good. Because clearly you need to do that so that you can push the box over there. But why would you do that? Wait, you can float up. We can actually go to the heavens. That's pretty cool, too. I like that a lot. But unfortunately, you can't go up vertically, which kind of sucks. Because I really want to. That would have been fun. But that's okay. All right. But let's see. What else can we do with this thing? And where else can we go? We can leave the box there. We can peer around this corner. But we don't really see anything down there. We can check out this. We can plunge over here. Okay. Tudster, I don't know if you're back. Welcome back. Good to see you back. We're trying to solve puzzles. We're trying to do things. Was that your little brother? Was it? We don't know. It was. How did you know? All right. Orange. So I don't know, you guys. The most progress we can make. Yeah, he is. He is. I think the best we can do. Is that the best you can do? Is this is the custom level, AK Noxus. It was made by Tudster. And I'll tell you one thing. If you want to know what we can do, we can take this and put it here. That turns off the tractor beam. We can get back by going here. And here. After we're back, so as long as we can reach this platform or that platform, we can get back up to the button. We can hit the button, which removes the box from the switch, which means that tractor beam turns on again. Question is, why is it good to even have the tractor beam off or on? I don't know. The only thing I can think of is that you can get momentum here by doing this. I know you probably need the box, but you need to move the box up. You guys, I'm out of ideas. Does anyone have any hints or thoughts or anything? Because you can get a lot of momentum this way. But that doesn't help you. Like, you can basically get wherever you want to. There are a few unanswered questions. Why is this giant space available down here? Why does the sewer look so creepy? I know sometimes in Rockman's levels, sometimes there were areas that were really dark. But this whole level's really well lit. It seems so simple, too. Like, there's not a lot going on here. It's not like there's a ton of crazy rooms or really confusing atmosphere. It seems like I should be getting it. But we only know two things. We can turn on, dang it. But it's nothing hidden in the shadows. There's a couple things we know. I really like the music of this game. One thing we know We can push ourselves wherever we want. If you guys have any ideas, let me know. I'm pretty dang stuck. We can check out this area again. That was suicidal. Where are the baddies? There are no baddies. It's just a puzzle game, Akinarxis. I mean, in the main game, there's like a boss. But it's a puzzle game. Just gotta solve the puzzles. One step at a time. So that's what we do. That's what I do, I solve the puzzles. Dang it. I don't know, I kind of think it would be a cool thing to just once in a while just... putting the cube on the button, it's somewhere else? Just once in a while, like, take on some... Is that too big of a spoiler? I don't know, man. It's your level, you decide what is too big or what is not big enough of a spoiler and stuff like that. It's all up to you, man. Well, I mean, there's only two things you can do with this. You can put it on that switch, obviously. You can put it here, but that kills it. There's no use in portal gunning anything because it'll get wrecked as soon as you leave this room. Maybe you can put it up here. But I don't even know if that does any good. I don't know, you guys. Where else? You can't put it anywhere else, though. This does nothing useful. Unless I shield it with my body to prevent it from dying. Which doesn't work. You can't make portals inside that space. You can't make portals and leave the space either. So it's definitely tricky. The box into the goo? Well, that doesn't really make sense. I mean, you could leave the box somewhere. I don't see any goo. You could, you help if you knew. Okay. Well, I appreciate the help if you knew support, Akinarxis. We can leave this box wherever we want. And then create the portal area over there. Put the box into the slime pit? Are you serious? I didn't think you could put anything in the slime pit. Makes a new box out. Oh, I see what you're supposed to do. Okay. That's actually really clever then. So I'll let you guys try and figure it out if you haven't yet. But it is a really clever puzzle. Put yourself in the slime pit. I like that. I will go in the slime pit. And it will be slimy! So this is what you're supposed to do. Wait a minute. I have no idea. Hey Vash, what's up, man? Glad you're still here. You haven't said anything in a while. Hey, I didn't know I could do that. I just like tipped the box. Tip your waitresses. Even if they're boxy. Look at that. That's so cool. Heh heh. You guys, I'm actually stuck. The one thing I figured out doesn't solve the puzzle. With you switching directions all the time? Okay, I'll just stare at one area for a long time. You're gonna go AFK a bit. So what we can do... I think... we have to have the tractor beam firing here. We have to have some way. I think I got it. We gotta put the portal here. No wait, I don't know. I don't got it. I'm so close to figuring this out. What you have to do involves something with destroying that box. You have to destroy the box. It falls down. You put a portal. I'll try and move slower. If you put a portal here, on this area, then it would go over there. If the box falls down from there, which it does, then it'll push the box into that square. Steffi Pie streaming? What? We might have to end so we can raid her. I really like Steffi Pie's stream. She's awesome. If we push the box over there, then we're going to solve the puzzle. Wait a minute, the box can't go through the port. Wait, yes it can. We have to find a way to push the box. To kill the box. We have to kill the box. But the problem is, if we use this switch to kill the box, then push it somewhere else. Yeah, exactly, Fusu. The thing is, if we push that box, I don't know, you guys. It's a mystery, man. You have to destroy the box, but you have to be out here. You can't enter that room. Because if you do, it's going to destroy all your portals. You have to keep your portals alive. You have to keep it like that. But you have to destroy the box. How can you destroy the box without leaving this area? I think I got it. I know how to destroy the box. I think I figured it out. I kind of like that though, Tudster. I like when it gives you a lot to think about, but not necessarily all the tools that you have to use help solve the puzzle. Because then it's kind of like process of elimination. When I start building more levels, I'm thinking I'll probably build more with elements where there's multiple solutions, and as a result of that, you can not need everything that's available to you. So what I can do now, I can put on a tractor beam to push this, which will kill the box. As soon as I move that tractor beam, so I don't need the switch at all. All I need to do is get over there. I actually don't even need that switch either. I don't need to have the box on the switch.
Excuse me.
I'm sorry, I just sneezed twice. Yeah, I see what you're saying, man. You have to get over there. I really like this puzzle, though, because it's so simple. As in, it's so elegant. The level that you... If you played my level, which I think you said you did, there's like four little parts to it. This level is cool because it's all just one big puzzle. And one simple thing. And I get it. You have to put the box over here. So now, I do like one room things. Mevius? I'll have to check him out. Now we can actually do something really cool. If we can do this right. So we actually want to have this orange portal line up perfectly with... Do you ever wonder, Tudster, that like you're going to make a puzzle and you overlook something, and instead of people having to be really clever to solve it, they like think of some really, really simple solution that you never thought of? Oh, I messed that up. That's what I worry about. You do it all the time? Okay. Yeah, because a lot of times I end up, when I was making my level, I just like put a lot of unportable space around the level. So it's like, you are not going to solve this using some crazy technique. So basically what I'm trying to do here is, let's see. I actually just want to destroy the box, put it in a convenient location to get destroyed, so that way when we destroy it, we can make it respawn where we want to. And then we'll use the portal to push it right across. So let's put that there. So now that we did that, we can put this there, and this should solve the puzzle. Watch, it's gonna fall, and there we go. No! It unsolved. We solved it the wrong way. Alright, well, we can solve it the right way. We're gonna have to move that cube again, though. But what's the right way? Alright. Okay, we went across. The question is, where did that... There's the box. Hello, box. I guess the box fell down. Let's just put the box back here. The question is, where do we want to zoom in from? Return to game. Dang, return. There. Where do we want our portals to go from? Yes, the bouncy gel is so much fun, Tommy. It really is. Put a portal there. But where do we stand? We have to stand in a location. Wait a minute, I'm getting even more confused. After we open up the gate, how do we get back? We can open up the gate and it's not a problem. Like, I can do this, and this, and then I can do this, and this, and I do this. This. Oh, cool! I can push myself backwards? I didn't even notice that. I don't know why I'd want to. I guess so you can switch polarity. Problem is, from here, you can't see. I guess you do have to reverse polarity. Wait a minute. I thought I had your puzzle figured out. I still don't get it. How do you... Mutant you? Okay. Mute me! Mutiny! Mutiny! So, what do we do here? I mean, we can do that. And that drops the box down. Well, I guess we will, because we don't really have any other answers. But then the problem is, now that we're down here, if we do anything... it's going to drop the box. So we're going to lose all our progress. Dude, I need a hint. If anyone has any ideas, let me know. Because that opens up the door. But how do you get over there? So it's basically like... if it were like this, how would you get up there? You got hints? Take a screenshot? Alright. Well, I'm down. But let's see where we can go. And what we can do. Yeah? I'm sorry to hear that, Tommy. I really am. That really sucks. That really, really is unfortunate. I might actually call it a stream soon. Maybe after we beat this level. Maybe I'll play my test level and show you guys what you're supposed to do. I really like my level. But we'll probably do that and then end the stream. But it's been really cool. We haven't done a nighttime stream before. I know it's been like super chill since we switched over to Portal. But we'll be back tomorrow. No, I actually don't really want to play my own level. Because then I'd just be... it'd be like a walkthrough. Wait, it's loading! Okay. I'll wait for it to load. Yeah, that's what I was thinking. That wouldn't be fun. I'm just really, really proud of... okay, candy kills, lol! Let's try that. Well, shoot a portal down and elevate yourself. Thank you for the suggestion and welcome to the stream. Candy Kills, LOL. How are you doing? Welcome and good to see you. I know I've been, I don't know how long you've been here, but I've been like really, really quiet and chilled. Well, we've been trying to solve this puzzle. Normally I'm like really, really excited and amped up. But what can I say? It's been a long day. But I'm really glad. Well, I'm glad you're back. Welcome back, Nick. How are you doing, man? We're taking on Portal. A few levels in Portal. We're taking a break from Lost Levels for a little bit. While we take on some custom levels in Portal. I may end the stream soon, though. Because I am pretty tired. But welcome back, man. We got to like 5-4 in World 5, Level 4 in Lost Levels. And we're stuck on this level now in Portal. I see what you're saying. Elevate yourself. The thing is that you've got to have a portal Like over here? So then, I'm not sure how elevating yourself buys time. It does, Nick, you know it. It really does. Puzzle games are really hard for me. I'm bad at being observant. The thing is, like, you can't go up from here. There's no way to elevate yourself. You have to be over there. You have to be down here, I think, to be able to see, to set that up and that up. So I don't see how that helps. Late night stream indeed, Hazer. Welcome. Good to see you, man. How's everything going, buddy? Yeah, we're taking on a custom level in Portal. It's really... You're doing it backwards. Really, Vash? You think so? It's ending soonish. I don't know. Maybe I'll do... Now a lot of people are coming out of the woodwork, so maybe I'll do another level. Maybe we'll do another one. How are you doing it backwards? Well, you guys are talking about going up to buy time. Maybe you go up so you can get a better angle on life. So you're music fatigued? Did you work too hard on playing an instrument or something? Other than that, you're good. Awesome. Well, glad to hear you're otherwise good. That's exciting, at least. I am just fatigued in general. I'm super sleepy, man. I'm exhausted. It's been a long day. I was really exhausted from work. And I was disappointed I didn't stream very long. That's why I did a late night stream today. Because I had to go work to work. And I was like, I don't want to work. How am I doing it backwards? There's definitely something I'm missing. I don't see how elevating... You guys are talking about elevating yourself, but I don't see how that helps. I mean, you can do this. Maybe that is what you're supposed to do. If you elevate yourself... And then you push yourself through... But then you don't have any way to get the angle that you need. To shoot the portals over there to kill the box. You mean move the orange portal? Why would I want to move the orange portal? I don't see the point in that. I mean, I can move the orange portal wherever I want. It's not going to do any good. The white square? But this doesn't help either. If you do this, you're just gonna get shot through here. Then your portals all die. And you can't do that. I don't get it, you guys. This is too deep for me. Yeah, it does. It does what? It does ruin the puzzle. Are you sure this is something you can complete? I don't know, man. This is a pretty involved puzzle. I mean, you can play with these. You finished it in your head? Are you sure you solved it correctly, Vash? I thought I solved it in my head like 4 times. All in one motion? You can do that. I'll do that, but I don't think it'll help. It's gonna require a bit of setup, but I don't think it's gonna do any good. Because you can go like this. And where's the blue? Unless, like, you shoot a portal. Wait a minute. That's not going to work either. The thing is, if you're flying across, there's, like, a problem. The problem that if you're flying across, then you can't have the field down if you haven't taken the thing and pushed the button yet. And if you're flying across, then you can't have the button push because you're not ready for that yet. Then if you do like this, I am? Like right now. So I don't want to ruin this setup because it takes a while. But I can shoot the thing. I can shoot the portal right here. And shoot across. That'll knock the thing down. While I'm crossing this, I could shoot another portal up there, which is going to shoot something across there. But as soon as I shoot that portal, it's going to drop me down into the acid, which is going to ruin everything. I am very lost too. Oh, F6, okay. This is what we can do. This is what I had in mind. And then going something like that, but it just, it's not gonna work. I don't understand what you guys are talking about. Doing it backwards? Oh, F7 warps back in time, okay. I mean, like, you can do this. I don't know either. This is, like, so involved. You can't get across. You have to be doing 2 things at once. You can't get across and push the button. You can do one or the other. I don't get it. I'm so lost, you guys. I mean, you can go across like this. And then you can drop down. And shoot another portal here. But this is just what I've been doing all over again. But then you're stuck. Like a rat in a trap. What is what? Well, we push the switch by putting the thing there, then pushing the tractor beam over here, so that that little thing drops a thing down. That doesn't make any sense. There's an opening under the shield? Oh, yeah, there is under there. But you can't portal under it down there. Nick Grizzly joined us more recently. I think it was during Sunshine. He started watching Tame. So I don't think he saw much or any of Portal 2. Been AFK. Yes, I'm still stuck on the first level. Play my custom level for a guaranteed 5-hour completion. Dude, have you added me on Steam, Irritating Pimple? I'll totally check that out. No, no need to apologize. I completely understand. Yeah. Yeah, during Sunshine! Yes! Sunshine was awesome. Sunshine was really hype. I'm still excited about Sunshine, even though we beat it already. I love Sunshine. I think it's such a great game. So there's enough time? Yes, you added me. Okay, awesome. We'll check that. I'm kind of exhausted right now, so we'll probably beat this level and call it a night, I think. But there's enough time? To fall down and respawn while you do the thing? You can't fall. If you fall, you're out of the race. You're just dead in the water. You can't fall anywhere. The only place you can fall is if you have the portal going across up there, over to that switch. You can fall down and then create another one that goes across like this. But that doesn't help. Like, this is the only fall you can have. If you have a fall like this. And that even killed me! Where do you need to move the box? Someone did a scary voice. What?! Why are people doing scary voices? You need to move the box over to that switch right there. So if you, what you have to do is you have to kill the box. Like, I'll do it now. Oh crap, I messed up. 7. If you kill the box, then it'll push it across. So yeah, it pushes it across. Then we can go. The only way I can figure this out is if you go down. And then you. Ah, dang it, I messed it up. Then you make another portal up above. And then when the box respawns, it creates the tractor beam over there. Yeah, I'm trying to figure it out too, man. It's really tough. So basically, I'm trying to demonstrate for you. When there's this tractor beam over here, see how it's pushing the switch? If you kill the box will respawn right up there. And then when it falls down to the tractor beam, dang it. It'll get caught in the tractor beam. Try from the platform that the tractor beam is on. You can't do anything from this platform. Because you can't target that area. You think you solved it? Why am I the last one to solve it? You can't target anything useful over there, because you can't... Unless you put the portal over here, and you have one waiting over there to kill the thing. I'm overthinking it. Man, people always say that! I don't know what that means. If I have a portal here... If I leave an orange portal here... You solved it! Awesome! Everyone's solving it! If you leave a portal here... While you're over there... Let's do that. We'll leave a portal over there. And we'll do this. Yes, we do. And then we need to get over there. And then we'll succeed. Dang it. So then we can do this. Alright, I hear you, Tommy. I'm gonna end soon anyway. But thank you for being here. It's been really, really awesome that you could stay with us as long as you did. I really appreciate it. And thank you for supporting the late night stream. As always, it's been really awesome having you here, Tommy. I appreciate it. Thank you so much. Bye. Good night. See you later. Okay. So we can do this. And then when we're over here, we can push the box over. Let's F6 here. Yeah, sure thing, Tommy. Definitely. I love streaming. It's so much fun. Now that should be killing the box. So then when we do... this, it'll recreate it here. But now we can't get over there. It's a problem. Unless we go up. Yeah, sure thing, guys. We are going to be resuming Mario tomorrow. Yeah, I guess I have to F7. And so you have to elevate yourself. You have to do this. Wait a minute, that's wrong. F7. And to do this. And then you have to shoot the orange one down to elevate yourself up. And then shoot a blue one there. That's gonna be orange and then blue. Did we catch the box? Oh, we missed it. Dang it. I think we got it figured out, though.